Welcome everyone. I am Uma Maheshwari, AP Chennai Department, RMD Engineering College. In this session, we are going to discuss about the subject Power Electronics. Subject code is E8552 and the unit of discussion is Unit 4, Inverter. In the inverter, we will go through the introduction part of it. What is an inverter? The inverter converts the DC power into AC power. AC power can be, output voltage can be varied and the frequency is also varied. Such kind of conversion is known as inverter operation. So, an inverter which converts fixed DC to variable AC. The output voltage can be controlled and the frequency can be controlled. Such conversion is known as inverter. And the main important applications of inverter are adjustable speed AC drives, induction heating, aircraft power supplies and uninterruptible power supplies. Now we will move to the classification of the inverters. So depending upon the output characteristics, the inverters are classified as square wave inverters, sine wave inverter and modified sine wave inverter. So this is your waveform of square wave inverter and the output, this represents the sine wave inverter. And the modified sine wave inverter is a stepped wave, modified sine wave inverter. So these are the classification of inverters depending upon the output characteristics. And depending upon the source connected to the input, it is classified as current source inverter or voltage source inverter. So when the input is current source connected, it is said to be current source inverter. And when the input connected is voltage source, it is said to be voltage source inverter. And now the classification depending upon the type of load. So if the inverter, the load, it is a single phase inverter or three phase inverter. The load connected is single phase, then the inverter is single phase inverter. It is again classified as half bridge inverter and full bridge inverter. Whereas when the load connected is three phase load, when it is said to be had three phase inverter. And the classification of three-phase inverter is 180 degree mode and 120 degree mode of operation. So depending upon the duration of the gate pulse, it is classified as 180 degree mode and 120 degree mode. And depending upon the different pulse width modulation techniques, the inverter is classified as single pulse width modulation and multiple pulse width modulation and sinusoidal pulse width modulation and modified sinusoidal pulse width modulation. And according to the number of output levels, it is classified as two-level inverter and multiple-level inverter. Now, with respect to the type of load, that is the single-phase inverter, we'll discuss about the single-phase half-bridge inverter in this session. So, when the inverter load is connected as a single-phase, generally a residential load or a commercial load which requires single-phase supply, we go for conversion inverter, that is the single phase inverter, which is again classified as single phase half bridge inverter and single phase full bridge inverter. Now we'll see the discussion of single phase half bridge inverter. So this is the circuit diagram of single phase half bridge inverter. Here you can see the supply voltage is DC, Vs by 2 in the upper half and Vs by 2 in the lower half, and the resistive load is connected. And the voltage across the resistive load is marked by the polarity V0, symbol V0, and the polarity of the V0 is represented, plus here and minus here. Here you can see there are two thyristors connected, thyristor T1 and thyristor T2. And there is a feedback diode connector which is connected across the thyristor T1 is D1 and the diode D2 is connected across T2. So this diode D1 and D2 are known as the feedback diode. So we are going to discuss about the resistive load in this session. So when an inverter, for an half-bridge inverter, when a resistive load is connected, we are going to see the output voltage waveform and the output current waveform. So these first two waveforms are the gate pulse for the thyristors. So first waveform represents the gate pulse for thyristor T1 and the second waveform represents the gate pulse for thyristor T2. So we are giving control signals to the thyristors to turn on for a definite interval of time. So when from instant 0 to T, from instant 0 to T, thyristor T1 is in on condition. This is your instant T. 0 to T, thyristor T1 is given gate pulse. So when the thyristor T1 is given gate pulse, at that time the gate pulse is not given to thyristor T2. So thyristor T2 is said to be in offset. So how about the current flow in thyristor T1? Power is flowing S by 2. So the upper half voltage, it is Vs by 2. Okay. So this is your output voltage waveform during the on cycle. Okay, during the on cycle of thyristor T1. And the output current is nothing but Vs by 2 divided by R. And during the period from T1 to T2. Let me name this period as T2. Let me give the naming as small T1 and small T2. So from this instant T1 to T2, thyristor T2 is given gate impulse. And the gate impulse for thyristor T1 is removed. So here, what is happening here? So during the thyristor T2 interval, that is this interval, thyristor T2 is conducting, how about the current flow? So the current is flowing from the positive through the board, through the thyristor to the negative. So the current is flowing in this manner, which is opposite to that of the assumed polarity, positive polarity. And the voltage polarity is positive here, negative here, which is opposite to that of the assumed positive polarity. So we are able to obtain an output voltage in the negative value, which is equal to minus Vs by 2. And we are also obtaining the current in the negative manner, minus I0, which is equal to minus Vs by 2 divided by R. So this is your waveform when thyristor T1 is conducting and T2 is conducting. After the interval, conduction of the T2 interval, again thyristor T1 is given gate impulse. The cycle repeats. Whenever thyristor T1 conduction, the output voltage is positive. And whenever thyristor T2 conducts, the output voltage and output current is negative. So in this manner, the DC is converted into a square wave AC like this. So inverter conversion is fixed DC to variable DC. We are able to vary this DC by modulating the pulse width using the pulse width modulation technique. So this is your output waveform for single phase half bridge inverter for R load. And here you can see that the magnitude of the output voltage waveform is half of the supply voltage. And here, because of the source utilization period is 50%, which is a disadvantage of half bridge inverter. To resolve this, we go for full bridge inverter. And here, in case of half bridge inverter, the Fourier series, the V output expression is represented as summation n is equal to the 135 to infinity 2VDC by n pi sine of n omega t. So this is for single phase half bridge inverter. Thank you, everyone.